Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. As you know from our website and our videos, we do a lot of building. We do a lot of ground up, we do a lot of renovation. And of course, we have our products that you can buy freestanding that you can put in your existing room and treat your existing room, which may or may not be the right size and volume for your usage. And that's why you're using treatment, because things aren't sounding good. So the first thing we're going to talk about today is in building. When you're really serious about sound, you've decided, you know, I'm tired of using Band-Aids in existing rooms. I'm going to build my own room. I'm going to dedicate it to what I want to do in that room, whether it's recording, playback, or whatever it is. So I'm going to call a guy like Dennis. I'm going to get the proper room size, volume, and usage, a proper room size and volume to match what I'm doing. If I'm just recording vocals, I don't need an auditorium. But I don't need a closet either. And that's why most vocal rooms sound like we talked about in other videos. So the bottom line here is, if you match the usage to the size and the volume, or match the size and the volume to the usage, you start to see breakpoints where a little bit more of this would help with that. A little bit larger volume would mean less low frequency absorption if it's going to be a live room and we're going to be recording drums or choirs or lots of sources. So there's breakpoints, trade-offs in real estate that you're going to use, the amount of labor that's involved, and obviously the amount of materials that are involved. Low frequency management is one of the most expensive treatments that you're going to have to prepare for in your budget. So because it has to be treated almost every place in the room. So how much, where, and all of that, what frequencies we're dealing with, that all has to be analyzed. But the goal when you're designing and building a room from scratch is to always keep this low frequency requirement in mind, because it's the most expensive to treat. So you have to choose the right volume to match what you're doing in the room. And there are, like we say, breakpoints, and we know those. Where maybe if you're 23 foot in length and you go to 27 foot, it might cut your low frequency absorption costs 25%, but only increase the size of the room 5 or 10%. So we know from our experience in building all of these rooms that we know where these breakpoints are. And that's why I always tell people, when they come to me with a specific footprint in mind for a project, say, can you give me another 4 feet on the length? Can you give me another 3 foot on the width? Can you give me another 3 foot on the height? Because I know if you can give me that for the shell, I know I'm going to cut your low frequency cost down, and then we can use money for other things. What's our next cost? Diffusion, especially quadratic. Quadratic diffusers are labor intensive. They're not difficult, but they're labor intensive to build, and they have a lot of parts, and the parts are all wood. So the cost is rather expensive. You have to use wood because wood gives a more natural, warm sounding tone, especially your softwoods, for diffusion. So quadratic diffusion would be your next expensive cost when you're considering a build, with low frequency being the first. So like we said before, to minimize your low frequency costs, get the right size and volume. And a few feet can mean a huge difference, especially when you're dealing with live rooms where you have full range instruments. A drum set will produce sounds from 40 cycles all the way to 8,000. So we can handle the 8,000 in almost any room size, but the 40 cycle energy, completely different story. So how do we do that with drums? We put the low frequency absorption right under the drum. We build it into the platform. Elevates it off the floor, which is best for pressure, and absorbs closest to the source. So all kinds of things we can do. But when you're building your room, you're always thinking about cost. I've got X amount of space. I got X amount of money. And we want to match the space, usage, and volume to the amount of money you have and make sure we're addressing the issues first. Now, a lot of times we can phase it. You start to see the numbers and you start to see the cost, you realize, oh, I don't have enough money to do what I really want. So then we address the first issues that are the most important first, and that's low frequency. Because if you don't have the low end right in a room, you're never going to have anything else right. So we want to get the low end right. Because remember, a 40 hertz problem is also a problem at 80, 120, 160 because of our harmonics. So the fundamental is the beginning of the nightmare, and then the harmonics are the end of it, okay? So match size, volume, treatment to cost. It's all a juggling act, and it's a ratio. Where do you go to find this information? Only experience can give it to you. I've been building buildings for 40 years. I have a lot of experience, and I've been building sound and acoustic rooms for the last 15. And I've built over 135 now, I think. So that database and that experience is available to you. So please don't hesitate to call. I'll be more than happy to share it with you. And let's know what we're doing first before we do it. Saves time and money and aggravation. And then we know what your end result is going to sound like. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.